Hi everyone, it's Rebecca, and today I'm back on behalf of Wild Orchid Crafts, the Wild Bunch, to share another project with you guys, so I hope you enjoy. So today, as you can see here, I have four different projects to share with you guys, and they are, of course, cards, as you can see here. And I think I've mentioned on one of my recent videos that I needed some birthday cards and just, greeting cards as such. So I have been busy making some. And these are actually special cards, as I like to call it, because they actually hold a little treat right here. And what I'm going to do, I'm just going to move these aside, and one by one, I'm going to go through each of them so that you guys have an idea of what products I have used. So first of all of the images that I have used are La La Land stamps, and the papers are actually just a bit of a mixture. Some of them are die cut with a view, and some of them are actually Prima papers, and the cardstock is just Basel cardstock. So anyway, so this is the first one right here. And isn't she cute? I love this image. She has a cupcake in her hand, so I thought I would use her. So, starting with the background, I just did some layering here with some punched out pieces and also some die cuts. And I just used my Spellbinders for most of the background here. And then this is a Fisker sponge. Here on the background, I have this cute little lace here. And then I have this pretty bow here, which is, of course, seam binding from Wild Orchid Craft. And then here I've just got a piece of crystal here, which is actually from a necklace that I had. And then right here is one of the crown pins. And by the way, as always, I will have all the codes down below for all the Wild Orchid Craft products that I have used so that you guys can go and check them out on the website. So here I've used one of the crown pins, and this is in blue. And then down below, I have just used this really cute bead cap that I have, which is a teapot, and you put a pearl in between, and it looks really, really adorable. And then here I've used one of the small gardenias, and this is the mixed pack. And then I've used some pearls here. And these pearls were actually a very light mint green, and I colored them in with my pearl markers so that I could have a coordinating color to go with this project. And then right here, I've used some stamens by Wild Orchid Craft as well. And if you can see here, they have this really nice texture. They're not just smooth, they look like they have pollen on them. So I really like that, and I just used some there. And then here's just a blue cherry blossom, and I've added some ribbon roses here, which is from my stash. And then this is what the inside looks like. So, of course, I have decorated the inside as well. And here on the side, you can see here it's just a little box. And this is actually a template that I have. If you guys have seen on my channel, I have used a similar template to this before, and I've made a card with some tea candles. And that was actually a Christmas card. This time I've changed the template a bit because I wanted a different shape of card. I just wanted a bigger card, as you can see here. And I think this is a 6 inches by 4 1/4, I believe. So anyways, here on the side you have this cute little box here to add whatever you want, really. So in this case right here, I just added some chocolate, and in this case it just happens to be this one right here. And the little box just opens up on top and bottom, and I'll just take this out so that you guys can see, and it just looks like that. And I had these little self-sealing bags here, and it just happened to fit perfectly in the little box, so that's what I used. So yeah, that's card number one. And oh, and by the way, this is what the back looks like. I basically just added this cute little stamp, handmade by, and I just need to sign my name there, and the card is all done. So the idea of the cards are all pretty much the same. I just basically decorated them differently. So this one, you can see here, I've used a different kind of sweet. I've used the Skittles, this one right here.
And I've used a different image, of course, but like I said, they're all La La Land stamps. So here on the button, I've used one of these pink carnations, which I absolutely adore. And then this one is one of the wild roses, and this is the white with the pink center. And then right here, I've added a open rose, and here on top, I've got another one there. And I think these are the 15 millimeters. So I'll have the code down below as well. And then some more open roses right here. And then right here, I've got one of those rose buds that I absolutely love, and this is the pink. And then I've used another Wild Orchid Craft pin right here, and this is just the head pin, and this is the pearlescent white, and I've just used another one of those bead caps that I had in my stash, and it looks like a teapot. And then here I've used some more of the seam binding, and this one is the pink salmon. And in the center, I've used some ribbon buckles from Wild Orchid Craft as well. I've used one of the silver, one of the pearl, and then I've used a pearl in the center. And then I've added some bling right here and some on the top. And just this really cute sentiment here. And it just says, I'd share my cupcake with you. And I thought that that was really adorable. So that's card number two. And then the inside looks like this. And the back is just the same. And then next card is this one right here. And again, I've added a different suite here. I've actually added these M&Ms. And this is a limited edition, just the British one. So all you get is the red, white, and blue. And I just thought that as soon as I had these colors on this card, that would be appropriate. So anyway, again, a different image right here. And here on the top, I've added some more of those super cute stamens right there. And I've added some more of the open roses as well. And here in the center, I have one of the ribbon roses that I have from my stash. And I have another one right there. And then here I have some 10mm open roses, which is so adorable. And on this one, I actually added some of the natural skeleton leaves. I hope you guys can see that. There's two there. And then I've added this beautiful rose right here. And I just had this in my stash as well, which is from a jewelry. And I just made like this double bow here with some organza ribbon. And then here's some more pearls, which I also colored in. So as you can see, you don't have to have all colors of the rainbow, of course, because you wouldn't be able to buy every single color out there. But if you have a light color, like I did here, you can easily color them in with your pearl markers, and they look really cute. And it's the same thing as I did for this one right here. However, this one was from my stash. So anyway, that's what this next card looks like. And this is what it looks like inside. And again, the back is just the same. And last one, actually, I think this is probably my favorite. I absolutely love Parisian themed things, and I've been there, and I just love Paris. So anyway, this is more like a Paris themed card, because I have a little Eiffel Tower right here, and I've used this really neutral kind of colors. And actually for this one and this one, I did some paper piecing on the dress. So it's just some pattern paper. And this one happens to be the Prima Romantique paper, which is matching with the paper here on the background. So that's what her dress is right here. And then the rest I did the coloring with my pearl markers. So in this case right here, I've added some seam binding, which is the camel hair, and I've done this double bow here, and I think it looks really cute. I've added some more of the skeleton leaves here on the top. Here I have got a cherry blossom, and then some more of those little roses, the open roses. And then here on top, I have the same sort of open roses here, two on the side, and then I have this other gorgeous two-tone brown rose right here. And in the center, I've just added another one of my ribbon roses. And here you can see I've added some more of those beautiful stamens. And I have some lace going on here on the background as well. So here, just another ribbon rose from my stash, and I've added some bling here to this card, which is from my stash as well. And the pearl here, again, I've done the same thing. I've colored it in. So this time I've actually colored it in brown, so it coordinated with this card. And in the center here, I've just used this beautiful filigree piece right here, which is from a jewelry that I had. And here, of course, I've added this little Eiffel Tower, which is so pretty. And it just dangles from here. And that's pretty much what this card looks like. And this is the one that I've used Prima Romantique papers as well in the background. So this is what this one looks like inside. You can see here I've used some more of the Prima Romantique. And here it is. So basically the back is the same again. So anyways, that's what I wanted to share with you guys. I just am in love with these cards. I think they turned out really, really cute. Anyways, I will have all the links below for all the products that I have used. I will also have the links to the website and their Facebook page and also the Wild Orchid Craft Design Team channel here on YouTube. If you guys haven't subscribed to that yet, I would definitely recommend for you to do so, because all of the other design team members have videos on that channel as well, so you might find it helpful. There's all sorts of inspirations there, and yeah, I hope you go and check it out. So thank you everybody for watching. I will see you next time. Bye.